of the youth in this community. And what I am saying, the complaint that I have this morning, that I want the whole country to listen to, Mr. President to also listen to me, is all about peace and security of this great local government. I am from another place called Ikobi. Since the 2nd of January, we have been attacked by herdsmen. Nobody from that community can reside in their place. We have been in the local government headquarters. More than how many community in Ikobi, Ogba, Ologba, Ugobi, Ijaha, Imana, Akpete, all these places that I'm mentioning for you, they are not staying in their places. Which government that will not protect its citizens? What kind of government is that? When the youth start shouting, you say they are making trouble. We are not making trouble. We have been protesting since morning. Nobody have ever raised arms or cutlass or anything. Fulani man will be rearing cattle with cutlasses, AK-47. Nobody will say anything. They have another immunity that they are operating that we Nigerians, we don't understand. The government should tell us if they have more power than other citizens of this country. As you look at this community, all the people you see around here, they are not from this community. They are from the community being displaced by the herdsmen. The community called Ugobi, under this same local government, a bidder chief was killed and the hand that controlled the bid was taken away by these same herders. And you want us to keep quiet? Which country are we? The government should tell us, where did we belong to? Are we also citizens of this country? I am asking questions and I need an answer. Soldiers will be around the community. See, the army, the Fulani herdsmen will be coming to behead people. What are they there for? Are they protesting us? Are they guiding the community? Or are they playing games with our lives? This is a pure video of what is happening in Borno State. There are some persons or individuals who will be making sure that there will be no peace in this country because they are benefiting from it. They should call the GOC commandant, 72 Battalion, Nasme Baras in the Makodi, ask them questions. The boys you posted to Apalo... Don't touch me. The boys you posted to Apaloka government to safeguard lives and property of the citizens in Apaloka government. What are they doing? We have two barracks in Makodi.
All right, wonderful people. All right, wonderful people. Welcome to Buhari's company in Nigeria, where the headers, terrorists have taken place, where they are rampaging and doing what they know how to do best by killing and maiming of souls and properties of people. Now you understand it. I am not the one that's saying this now. You know, I have been saying this from the day one, but people don't seem to understand. I have told people, your problem is Nigeria. Nigeria was built on fraud. The foundation of Nigeria was built on fraud. We are not one people. That is why you are seeing all these shenanigans every single day happening in Korokoro, and nobody is going to stop it. Because you see these Fulanis and herders, and those terrorists, they are working together. Mayati Allah is the foundation of all these terrorists you are seeing today. Mayati Allah is the root, and other people are the branches. I want you people to understand that these things that is happening, it have been happening for a long time, and we have been saying this, but nobody seems to understand. Those people that are coming to tell you that diversity is your strength, I have told you this time with that number, don't listen to these people. They are all deceivers. One thing that you have to understand on this concocted or fabricated country called Nigeria, because it is a fraud. Nigeria is against humanity. Nigeria is the worst place that human being can live, because they are killing and maiming of souls every single day in their own, what I don't know, called, conquest called holy war, the movement of jihadism. I keep on saying this to our people. Now, let me introduce myself before I go more further on what the reporter said. Because we are going to tag international community. Why we are tagging them is not for them to come and help us, but let them understand what people are passing through in that contraption every single day. All right, wonderful people. Freedom fighters, lovers of freedom, great people all over the world, you are welcome once again on IPOB Rapture Media under the leadership of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Here I am, I always set the record straight. My name is Mazi Okenna Okechukwu, known as the Biafran Child Wachineke, the General. Welcome to Buhari's company in Nigeria. We are the herdsmen that are going around with AK-47 sophisticated weapons and rifles are not responsible of what is happening today. They give them free hand. They can move with whatever they want. And they are killing and maiming people every single day. The government don't care. They are calling Buhari that is already dead, have already gone and was buried in Saudi Arabia in shallow grave. Now you understand what I'm saying. According to the reporter is from a place called Ikobi. That means that he have run away from his own community for his safety. So now he's not residing in his community. His community now is under Sare. They are destroying and killing and maiming of people. The Fulanis, the foreigners, the jihadist movement. They are there already killing people. They have touched these people. That is why this reporter now is calling to the Nigerian government. But I'm going to explain things to our people. You don't have to call Nigerian government. The Nigerian government, that themselves, they are the terrorists. They are the people that are funding the terrorists. They are the people that are commanding the terrorists in that contraption called Damnable Zoo. Now you understand. I want you people to know, according to this reporter that we just finished listening, because I want to bring out what he said. You know, I always bring authentic information to our people. I don't just bring things from my mind or coming here to fabricate or concocting stories. No, that is why I have gotten to that point that I will bring the video for you to see, then you begin to understand. Because in your place, they say that see is believing. You will see it. I hear it from the reporter so that you can be able to understand what is going on and the mess that you are into. Now, pay attention very well. According to the reporter, it says since the 2nd of January, the Fulanis have been attacking, the Fulanis, which is the herders, have been attacking their villages. And now he mentioned several villages. They have already, you know, controlled. They have already taken over the villages, which is the herders, which is the terrorists, which they are the Mehati Allah. Because some people don't understand that all these people, they are under Mehati Allah. Now, he said Igbo Oba and Oro Oba, Igbobi, Ijaha, Emana, and the Akwete. If I don't call it well, you listen to the report. All these places that I have called, all these communities, they have been taken over by Fulanis, by Mehati Allah, by terrorist groups in that contraption called Damnable Zoo. And all these villages that I have called, according to the report, none of them are living now in their own community. None of them. None of them. All of them, they have run away from. They want to save their soul. And according to the reporter, we have been saying this time with that number. That is the reason why Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is still today in DSS dungeon, because he has been telling the zoo called Nigeria the truth. We have said it. With the truth, we are going to balkanize that contraption called Damnable Zoo. With the truth. With no guns and bullets. With the truth, we are going to cease Nigeria to exist. We must go back to where we used to be before they came to brought oil and water together. We are not one. This is the main problem of that contraption. People are saying, let's fix Nigeria. But we are not one people. Now, according to the reporter also, he said Fulanis are going about with their cattle, holding AK-47, sophisticated weapon and rifles. Nobody ever questioned them. And the communities, those owns the communities, they don't even have a common stick. common 2x2 they don't have. But Fulanis are parading themselves with sophisticated weapon, killing and maiming of souls of the properties of people in their own community, in their own ancestral land. The foreigners are coming to take over. But whenever we are saying all these things, people don't seem to understand. And the reporter also said, the community called Igobi, the bid holder, which is the highest chief in that community, the bid holder, the Fulani, the terrorist Meati Allah, they killed this man and cut off his hand, the hand that is holding that bid. They cut it off and take it away from with them. Now you understand what I'm saying. Now do you understand what is playing in that contraption? Where it comes to Buhari's company in Nigeria, where the jihadism is the movement of the day, where they have sent their Quran into Atlantic Ocean, telling you that they must conquer. That is what they mean by conquest, the movement of jihadism. I am telling you people this. See, you know, sometimes when I'm saying this, some people will say, you don't have a job, you don't have, you talk too much. But now you have seen it, and I want you to circulate this video, to make it, to tag it to the international community. We are not saying that they should come and help, but let them know what is happening. That all these things that we have been saying, there is no lie about it. They should free Mazi Nnamdi Okuchukwukanu. Nigeria, obey your court order. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu have been freed and be acquitted, but you people are still holding him. The world shouldn't be mute on this. But we know in African way, or when they come in African part, they don't care. But the Nigerian should obey their court order. Malami, obey your court order. This is what I have for you people today. Circulate this video. Good day, and remain blessed.